On April 14th, 1912, the RMS Titanic struck an iceberg on its maiden voyage to New York City and was lost to the North Atlantic Ocean. In December of 1997, James Cameron's Titanic was released in movie theaters. The two fictional main characters in this film are third-class passenger Jack Dawson, an artist who's so high on life it's almost obnoxious, and first-class passenger Rose DeWitt-Picater, an outspoken, reluctant bride-to-be who's so smothered by status, she's suicidal. Notice, the boy is happy and has everything figured out, whereas the girl is unhappy and has nothing figured out. It goes without saying that these two fall in love, and it goes without saying that the ship they fall in love on sinks beneath them. But it's what happens afterwards that has been the subject of a fierce debate. Jack locates a piece of debris for the two of them to float on, but unfortunately, the physics don't cooperate with that plan. And as a result, Romeo dies. A lot of people are not satisfied with this outcome. They insist that there was enough room on that door for both of them, and hence they argue that Jack didn't have to die. Now, here's the thing. It is true that Jack didn't have to die. The premise of this argument is valid, but the discussion is focused on the wrong part of the story. Earlier that night, when the lifeboats were still being filled with women and children, Jack insisted that Rose climb into a lifeboat. And even though she didn't want to, she eventually did climb in without him. But before the boat was lowered all the way down, this happened.
Should I stay or should I go now? Should I stay or should I go now? If I go, there will be trouble.
Now, at first glance, you might think that Jack was being noble, that Rose was being loyal, and that this was kinda cute. But think about it. If Rose gets off the ship safely, Jack's life is the only life he needs to save, and he can therefore make a much more promising attempt to survive the sinking.
You have to go. Now.
No, Jack.
Get in the boat, Rose.
No, Jack.
Get on the boat!
So maybe instead, Jack was being pragmatic, Rose was being selfish, and this was counterproductive. After all, the unintended consequences of this dim-witted stunt are as follows. Both of them end up getting shot at, trapped in a flooded hallway, shoved against a gate, trapped behind another gate, nearly drowned, and by the time they get back to the deck, all of the lifeboats are gone. Fantastic. So, they make a break for the stern, where Rose slows them down,
wait.
Falls down, gets lost, gets lost again, nearly drowned again. In every single case, Jack saves the day, and that pretty much brings us back up to speed. Jack finds a piece of debris buoyant enough for only one person to float on. If Rose was willing to be a bit more rational and a little less, fireworks and slow-motional, she would have understood that while leaving Jack behind is not exactly ideal, jumping back onto the ship is going to make the situation worse. Had Rose rowed merrily away, Jack would have been the one floating on this door, he would have been rescued, the two would have reunited the next morning on the Carpathia, and they could have gone to New York together. So with that being said, what exactly was Rose's rationale?
Why did you do that? Why?
Jump high, jump right.
Wrong.
Damn it.
She's referring to how they met. A few nights earlier, Rose tried to kill herself by jumping off the back of the ship while it was floating. In case you were wondering what kind of person jumps onto it while it's sinking.
Wait a second, I want to get something straight. You were going to kill yourself by jumping off the Titanic? That's great.
Lewis.
All you had to do was wait 2 days.
Jack tried to talk her out of it by insisting that if she jumped, he would jump after her. Say what you will about you jump, I jump. It's a poetic reminder that your actions affect others. It's an oath that you're not going to let somebody harm themselves. It's not an excuse to be clingy. So to use a zinger like this, when in fact you just diminished another person's chances of survival, is about as ironic as an unsinkable ship sinking. If this wasn't frustrating enough, she also appears to contradict one of their other catchphrases. I trust you. Evidently, she didn't trust that Jack would survive the sinking. Or she didn't trust in his judgment. Oh, speaking of trust issues, this is not the first time that she's nearly gotten Jack killed.
Shit! Oh, shit!
Here we find the king of the world handcuffed to a pipe. How did that happen? Well, long story short, Jack was framed and Rose didn't believe him when he pleaded his innocence. Far be it from any one of us to know exactly why she didn't believe him. What, this whole time he was just pretending to like you so that he could steal this diamond that he didn't even know existed until you'd already fallen in love?
That's nice. What is it?
Well, we can rule that one out. Even if he did just decide to steal it out of the pun intended blue, couldn't she just assume that he stole it for the both of them? Okay, how about this? Why would he have gone back to the compartment if he stole something from it? Or does my jealous fiancé have a motive to frame the young man I've been running around with? Mind you, she shouldn't even have to rationalize any of this, because according to her, she trusts him.
Trust me!
I trust you!
Trust me?
I trust you.
It doesn't make any sense. That's why I trust it.
You keep using that word. I do not think it means what you think it means.
It's not like this is the first time that Jack has been arrested for something he didn't do. Rose defended him the last time this happened, and she didn't even know him. Since then, she's gotten better acquainted with him, formally dined with him, went dancing with him, made out with him, modeled naked for him, had sex with him, decided to get off the ship with him, and she still doesn't trust him.
You know I didn't do it.
Come on, let's go.
You know I didn't do it, Rose. Rose!
As if this young woman's insincerity wasn't insufferable enough, her indecisiveness is unprecedented. Even when she is told point blank that the ship will sink, it still doesn't occur to her to go back for Jack. Just needed a little bit more time to stare blankly around and think about it.
How did you find out I didn't do it?
I didn't. I just realized I already knew.
Now, this is not to say that Jack hasn't made any bad decisions himself. Going back to Rose's compartment might have been the dumbest judgment call since ignoring half a dozen iceberg warnings. At no point did it occur to him that he just drew this young woman naked, signed his name, and left it behind. Oh, wait a minute, Rose intentionally left it behind, in the safe, with a snarky little note, pretty much guaranteeing that her violent fiancé would find it. And yet she has the nerve to look surprised when he tells her he tore it up. With foresight like that, maybe this makes a little more sense.
You're so stupid, Rose!
And to think, if Jack had just minded his own business on day one, he might have lived a full life, this might have ended up in a museum, and Brock Lovett's career wouldn't have been destroyed searching for something that ultimately gets chucked into the ocean by a woman he flew thousands of miles out to the wreck site under the guise that she'd help him find it. No surprise, this is the same woman who lives 100 years and never seems to figure out that she's responsible for Jack's death. So, in hindsight, did Jack have to die? Well, no, he didn't have to die. But then again, he didn't have to chase after a narcissistic hypocrite who's indecisive.
I changed my mind.
What's more, the Titanic didn't have to sink on its maiden voyage. And for what it's worth, James Cameron didn't have to say this during his Oscar acceptance speech.
I'm the king of the world!
Yes, of course none of these things had to happen, but when you're only thinking about yourself and you make poor decisions as a result, regret tends to be a byproduct. So let's try not to confuse stupidity and self-interest with romance and valor. If we can manage that, we'll likely stay afloat. And if we can, here's the door.
Come on, way, way out into the water with me. We're drowning on dry land. Come on and way, way out into the water with me. Come on and way, way out into the water with me. We're drowning on dry land. Come on and way, way out into the water with me. Come on and way, way out into the water with me. We're drowning on dry land.
I mean, I love waking up in the morning not knowing what's gonna happen. Who I'm gonna meet. Where I'm gonna wind up. I figure life's a gift, and I don't intend on wasting it. You never know what hand you're gonna get dealt next.
This is horseshit! You know I didn't do it!
Hello, help me!
God damn it, son of a bitch!
You learn to take life as it comes at you.
Well said, Jack.
Yeah, yeah.